You won't work in networking long before you hear someone talking about the control plane and the data plane. At first, this can be quite confusing. What are they? What are they used for? What's the difference between them? We're here to demystify the control and data planes. In times past, communication was very manual. Think of an ancient general organizing his troops. He may post a soldier as a messenger. This soldier needs to listen closely for any messages or watch for any signals and be prepared to pass them on. He's not overly concerned with the message itself, he just needs to pass it on quickly and accurately. But there are also times when the messages are meant directly for him. Another soldier may be talking to him, maybe he's getting new orders, or maybe he's finding out about a shift change. In this case, our soldier cares about this message. He needs to listen to what's being said, think about it, and then respond. Our networking devices are like this soldier. A major part of what they do is receive traffic and pass it on quickly and accurately. This is the data plane, also known as the forwarding plane. This includes the FIB at layer 3 and switching at layer 2. Routers and switches will also make good use of technologies like Ceph, TCAM tables, and specialized ASICs if they're available. But these devices also need to be able to respond to traffic that's sent to them and to generate messages themselves. They need to participate in the conversation. This kind of traffic could include management, routing protocols, ping, monitoring, and so on. This is control plane traffic. The control plane is special as it's involved in controlling how data is forwarded through the network. Think of routing protocols, for example. The control plane can definitely affect the data plane. This includes altering and filtering data, like load balancing, firewall rules, and so on. You can roughly think of the control plane as the brain of the network. But why do we bother making a distinction between the two? One reason is technologies can be developed independently. You can take a router that you bought a few years ago and install new software on it, giving you new features. The control plane features are not locked into the hardware of the data plane. A second major advantage is seen in software-defined networking. If the data plane and control plane are separate, we can remove the control plane from the device. And now we have a separate device, such as an SDN controller, which manages how the network behaves. Our switches and routers can now simply focus on forwarding only. Think of our soldier again for a moment. Imagine if he gets too busy chatting to another soldier. He could get easily distracted or overwhelmed. This may make it difficult to do his real job. He might even miss something important. The same can happen in the network. The control plane utilizes the CPU regularly. So if the CPU gets fully utilized, the control plane suffers. If it gets too busy to handle any new packets, it may struggle with something critical, like OSPF or ERGRP. This in turn can cause a problem for the data plane. So as you can see, the control plane is a potential attack surface. If an attacker can overwhelm the control plane, perhaps with a ping flood or some other DDoS attack, they could compromise the whole device. This is why we can use control plane protection. This is where we limit the amount of certain types of control plane traffic that a device will accept. Some devices will have basic protection built in. Some more advanced platforms will let you configure the protection yourself, mostly through QoS policies. There's just one last thing I'd like to cover, and that's what is sometimes known as the management plane. The management plane is management traffic that's going to a device, like SSH, Telnet, Web Console, SNMP, and others. Strictly speaking, this is still control plane traffic, but you can treat it differently to other types of control plane traffic like routing updates, NetFlow, ping, and so on. This raises an interesting question. Is all management traffic control plane traffic? Well, it depends on the perspective. If management traffic is going to a device, then as far as this device is concerned, this is control plane traffic. If management traffic is going through a device, perhaps to manage another device somewhere else, then from the device's perspective, this is data plane traffic. So the simplified version of all of this is that when forwarding traffic, we're using the data plane. When generating or responding to traffic, we're using the control plane. I hope all this makes sense, and thank you for watching.